cosmic impacts, the threat may be hiding in the sun's glare. The concept of a phantom asteroid approaching Earth from the direction of the sun isn't science fiction. In 2022, a study published in the Planetary Science Journal estimated that 58% of asteroids with orbital inclinations greater than 30% and an affilion of less than 1.2 AU could approach Earth undetected until just 30 days before a potential impact. The reason is geometric. An object orbiting close to the ecliptic plane but with a steep inclination crosses Earth's orbit at blind spots relative to the Sun. While the probability of collision is low, detecting such objects is nearly impossible. A real example is the asteroid that exploded over the skies of Chelyabinsk on February 15, 2013. On a sunny winter morning, shortly after sunrise, a 20-meter, about 65-foot asteroid weighing around 13,000 tons entered Earth's atmosphere over the Ural Mountains in Russia, traveling at a speed of over 18 kilometers per second, or about 40,000 miles per hour. It was the largest asteroid to strike Earth in more than a century, and its sudden appearance was due to its approach from the same direction as the Sun. Could such an event happen again, perhaps even on a worse scale? Before diving into the main discussion, we'll start with a glimpse of what could happen in the near future. May 18th, 2036, 2:14 Coordinated Universal Time. Lanzarote Amateur Observatory, Canary Islands. Jose Maria Carreño, a retired dentist and amateur astronomer with a passion for searching for sun-grazing comets, was reviewing the latest images taken just after sunset when he spotted a faint, elongated dot of light about 20 degrees east of the sun. It was nearly invisible amidst digital noise, but by comparing it with two nearby field stars, he estimated its magnitude to be around 9. Resolving to follow up, he made a note to search for it again the next evening. May 19th, 2219 Universal Coordinated Time, Lanzarote Amateur Observatory, Canary Islands. J.M. Carreño rediscovered the object, which appeared significantly brighter, at least magnitude 8.2, and oddly stationary, its position having shifted by just 5 arc minutes compared to the previous night. Intrigued, he cross-checked the data against the Minor Planet Center's database and found no match. The object wasn't cataloged. Convinced he had discovered an asteroid or possibly a comet, he sent an alert to the international network. May 21st, 4:33 Universal Coordinated Time, JPL, NASA, Pasadena, California. A preliminary trajectory, hastily calculated using data from Lanzarote and the Japanese Himawari 9 telescope, indicated a 14% probability of impact in eastern Siberia. While the odds weren't alarming enough to trigger global alerts, they were sufficient to activate the verification protocol. The challenge lay in the object's orbital geometry. The asteroid, designated 2036 Ka9, was detected in the sun's proximity, a blinding region for both optical and space telescopes. The only available images came from two Chinese weather satellites, which had, by sheer chance, captured a blurry trace of it in the infrared spectrum. May 22, 1908 Universal Coordinated Time, Goldstone Solar System Radar, California. The 8.5 GHz bistatic radar transmitted a sequence of pulses towards the object. The returning signal, captured by the DSS-63 antenna in Spain, revealed an irregular shape, approximately 130 meters or about 427 feet in diameter, rotating every 4.7 hours. More precise orbital calculations painted a grim scenario. Even excluding the Yarkovsky effect, the MOID, minimum orbit intersection distance, was practically zero, and the asteroid was just 0.02 astronomical units away, about 3 million kilometers or roughly 1.86 million miles. The probability of collision with Earth on May 29th had risen to 47%. The estimated impact zone was the North Atlantic, with a margin of error of 2,500 kilometers or about 1,550 miles. The director of NASA's CNEOS, the Center for Near-Earth Object Studies, called for the activation of the IAWN, the International Asteroid Warning Network, the hub responsible for guiding governments in planning responses to cosmic threats. May 23rd, 7:09, Universal Coordinated Time. Goldstone Solar System Radar, California. Goldstone's antenna managed to track the object for 12 minutes, enough to establish it as a rocky body with a mass of 6 million tons and an average diameter of 162 meters, or about 531 feet. Traveling at a velocity of 18,000 kilometers per hour, or about 11,185 miles per hour, the estimated impact energy was equivalent to 150 megatons. The trajectory now pointed towards Central Europe, with an impact uncertainty window of 1,200 kilometers, or roughly 745 miles. The probability of collision had climbed to 78%. May 23, 2318, Universal Coordinated Time, the Pentagon. General Shaw, can we stop it with a nuclear warhead? We've got Trident 2s ready in North Dakota. Dr. Varma, JPL, it'd be useless. To fragment an asteroid this size, you need a 500 megaton device making direct contact. Our most powerful tests max out at 20 megatons. And even if we hit it, the fragments would cause multiple impacts. Shaw, then why the hell did we fund the DART project? Varma, DART works on smaller asteroids and with years of advance notice. Here we've got 120 hours, give or take. It'd be like shooting a bullet with another bullet in the dark. May 24th, 8 o'clock, Universal Coordinated Time. Emergency meeting, United Nations headquarters. I confirm there is a 97% certainty of impact along the northern European coast at 11:11 Universal Coordinated Time on May 29th, announces Dr. Helena Russo of ESA, pointing to a projected map. Estimated energy, 170 megatons. Without deflection, the airburst will create a thermal wave devastating an area of 8,000 square kilometers, or about 3,090 square miles. We cannot stop it, and that's the bottom line. UN Secretary General Karl Permessauer orders governments responsible for the projected impact zones to evacuate populations and secure the region as much as possible. May 29th, 11:09 Universal Coordinated Time. The asteroid enters Earth's atmosphere at a velocity of 19 kilometers per second, or about 42,500 miles per hour, and a trajectory angle of 32 degrees. At an altitude of 80 kilometers, around 50 miles above the North Sea, it begins to fragment. The first flash, with a magnitude of minus 28, brighter than the sun, is visible from Denmark, Germany, and England. At 35 kilometers, or roughly 22 miles, the dynamic pressure exceeds the asteroid's structural integrity. It explodes into a plasma fireball 12 kilometers, or about 7.5 miles in diameter, releasing 180 megatons of kinetic energy. The airburst, equivalent to 8,000 Hiroshima bombs, hurls a wave of fire towards the ground. In the following days, 500,000 tons of dust and soot are ejected into the stratosphere, dimming sunlight across the northern hemisphere. Crops across Europe rot, triggering widespread famine. Satellite communications are disrupted for months due to electromagnetic pulses. NATO collapses into a storm of accusations. Why hadn't the DART defense systems been activated? The answer was simple. No kinetic missile could be launched with so little warning. The only rocket available, a Falcon Heavy in Florida, lacked updated software for an emergency interceptor. By the time the world fully grasped what had happened, it was already too late for mourning. The lesson, if learned by anyone, was this. The universe is not malevolent, it is indifferent. And in that indifference lies the real terror. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. Yes, dear friends, the possibility that a large asteroid could strike Earth with no warning, arriving from the sun's direction, is a real vulnerability in our planetary defense systems, although statistically remote. To understand its implications, we need to examine not only the orbital dynamics that render some asteroids invisible, but also the technological limitations, observational blind spots, and physical complexities that hinder detection. Let's start with a fact. Near-Earth asteroids, or NEOs, are primarily discovered using ground-based optical telescopes that scan the night sky, searching for moving points of light against a backdrop of stars. However, the region of the sky within about 45 degrees of the sun is inaccessible to these instruments, both due to solar glare and the risk of damaging their sensors. This creates a blind spot that could hide incoming objects, especially those with orbits inside Earth's, such as Eteric-class asteroids, whose trajectories are entirely confined within our planet's orbital path. These objects spend most of their time near the sun from our perspective, only briefly emerging at dawn or dusk. Even then, their apparent brightness is minimal due to an unfavorable phase angle, the geometry determining how much reflected sunlight reaches Earth. An asteroid measuring 200 to 500 meters, or roughly 650 to 1,640 feet, with an inclined and resonant orbit relative to Earth's, could silently approach, leveraging the backlighting geometry to stay hidden. The sunlight reflected towards us would be so faint that the object's apparent magnitude would remain below the detection threshold, around plus 22 for the most advanced telescopes, until it reaches an observable position, potentially just weeks before impact. One of the most illuminating case studies is asteroid 2019 OK, discovered a mere 24 hours before its close flyby at 65,000 kilometers, or about 40,400 miles, in July of 2019. Although it didn't approach directly from the sun's direction, its highly eccentric orbit and relative velocity of 24.5 kilometers per second, around 55 miles per hour, made it entirely invisible until the last moment. Subsequent analyses revealed that in the weeks prior, the object had been in a region of the sky near the sun, with an apparent magnitude of plus 22.5, right at the limit of detectability, even for the most powerful telescopes. Had its trajectory been slightly different, an impact would have been plausible, delivering an estimated energy of 50 megatons, enough to obliterate an area the size of a major city. This incident highlights a structural issue. Asteroids approaching with phase angles greater than 150 degrees, nearly aligned with the sun, reflect less than 1% of sunlight back toward Earth, drastically reducing the likelihood of discovery. Dynamic simulations, such as those conducted by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL, suggest that an asteroid on a collision course from the sun's direction can only be detected once it reaches a distance of about 0.3 to 0.5 AU, or 45 to 75 million kilometers, or roughly 28 to 47 million miles from Earth, depending on its albedo, reflectivity. For an object traveling at an average relative velocity of 20 kilometers per second, or around 45,000 miles per hour, this would provide just 15 to 30 days of warning. However, if the asteroid followed a heliocentric orbit with a high inclination of over 40 degrees, the observable window could shrink to less than a week. In this case, the object would cross the night sky along an oblique trajectory, visible only from specific latitudes and for a limited number of hours. A theoretical example is the hypothetical asteroid 2021 PDC, used in a NASA simulation exercise. In that scenario, the object was discovered 21 days before impact, but initial uncertainties allowed confirmation of collision only 5 days prior to the event, making any practical response impossible. Technological limitations exacerbate the risk. Ground-based telescopes like those used in the Pan-STARRS program in Hawaii primarily operate at night and require up to 48 hours to confirm the trajectory of a newly detected object due to the need for multiple observations. In regions near the sun, even during twilight, the available observation window is limited to just 20 to 30 minutes per night and only during specific seasons. Additionally, most telescopes avoid pointing within 30 degrees of the sun to protect their CCD sensors from overload, creating a permanent dead zone. Space telescopes, on the other hand, could theoretically observe these regions, but instruments like NEOWISE, which operates in the infrared spectrum, have narrow fields of view and insufficient resolution to detect asteroids smaller than 100 meters, or about 328 feet, at distances beyond 0.3 AU, approximately 45 million kilometers or 28 million miles. A partial exception is NASA's Stereo A telescope, designed to monitor the Sun, which occasionally captures images of asteroids transiting near our star. However, Stereo A is not optimized for tracking NEOs and lacks the sensitivity needed to detect faint objects. Another critical factor is the angular velocity of asteroids approaching from the Sun's direction. If an object moves rapidly across the sky due to its proximity to Earth, automated telescopes may fail to distinguish it from background noise during brief exposures. Detection algorithms are calibrated to discard signals that are too faint or too fast to avoid false positives. An asteroid on its final approach, with an angular velocity of 2 to 3 degrees per day, typical for objects at 0.1 AU or roughly 15 million kilometers or 9.3 million miles, might appear as an indistinct streak in images, especially if its magnitude is near the instrument's detection limit. The implications of a sudden impact depend on the size and composition of the asteroid. A rocky body 300 meters or about 984 feet in diameter, with a density of 2.6 grams per cubic centimeter, would release energy equivalent to approximately 3,000 megatons, or 60 times the energy of the Tsar Bomba. This would be enough to create a 5-kilometer-wide or roughly 3-mile-wide crater and ignite fires on a regional scale. If the impact occurred in the ocean, it would generate tsunamis with wave heights of 50 to 100 meters, or about 164 to 328 feet, along coastal areas, as demonstrated by models from the University of California. Proposed solutions to address this gap include dedicated space telescopes positioned in orbits that allow them to observe near the Sun. For example, the NEO Surveyor, scheduled for launch in 2028, will use infrared sensors to detect heat emitted by asteroids rather than relying on reflected light. Since thermal emissions are less affected by phase angle, this telescope could identify objects approaching from the Sun weeks or even months earlier than optical instruments. However, even the NEO Surveyor will have limitations. Its resolution is optimized for objects larger than 140 meters or about 459 feet, and its sky coverage won't be continuous due to orbital constraints. More ambitious alternatives, such as constellation or microsatellites in inner heliocentric orbits, have been theorized but would require multi-billion dollar investments and complex international collaborations. In parallel, advances in orbital calculations and artificial intelligence are offering opportunities for improvement. Neural networks like those developed by the Minor Planet Center can analyze large astronomical data sets to retroactively identify faint traces of asteroids in archived images. In 2020, a machine learning algorithm uncovered 104 previously uncharted asteroids in Hubble data, showcasing the potential of these techniques. However, without initial observations directed towards the Sun's vicinity, even AI remains powerless. The risk of a sudden impact from a hidden Sun-obscured asteroid is a combination of low probability and extreme consequences, what's often referred to as a long-tail scenario that warrants preventative measures disproportionate to its immediate statistical likelihood. Earth's geological history, dotted with events such as the Chicxulub impact, 10 kilometers in diameter 66 million years ago, and the more recent Papagei crater, 35 kilometers 35 million years ago, reminds us that catastrophic impacts are inevitable over sufficiently long timescales. The challenge for humanity is to mitigate residual risk within the time frame of modern civilization by investing in advanced detection technologies and globally coordinated response plans. As long as a significant fraction of NEOs remain uncatalogued, and as long as the sky near the Sun remains unexplored, the possibility of a cosmic surprise will continue to loom as a troubling, though not unavoidable, uncertainty.